Top T Westbrook versus James Charles. Whose side are you on? Also, is this the worst season of Game of Thrones?
Plus, what country queen Kacey Musgraves refused to do on stage at a recent concert? This is The Download.
Hello, Internet. Welcome to The Download. Now, if it's flooding your timelines and you and your friends are obsessing over it, we're probably going to talk about it here. What's going on, guys? I'm Danny Directo.
And I'm Cassie DeLaura. And we can't forget about our producer, Brianna Sutton, who is joining us in the control room.
Hey, what's
happening?
You guys, take a look at that face and get familiar with it, because Brianna is going to be joining us throughout the show to give her opinions, her thoughts, her comments, her concerns, all of it.
As I spill the tea.
But first, you guys, it is the YouTube drama heard around the world. Tati Westbrook versus James Charles, and the fallout continues, you guys. Now a handful of celebs are appearing to take sides, and we want to know, which side are you on? Let us know in the comments below.
Don't they know that The Weeknd is typically reserved for Game of Thrones and those battles? Like, this is taking off still. The aftermath now.
The aftermath continues, and I feel like obviously we have to preface it a little bit for those who may not have heard, although that is probably population zero, but Tati Westbrook versus James Charles. Their sister ship has kind of hit an iceberg, and their friendship is no more after the two took to YouTube. Tati with a lengthy 40-minute video. 45-minute video, and I watched every second of it. I watched every single second of it. You know, kind of explaining the drama in the beauty industry, and specifically between her and James, which then prompted James to post his shorter 8-minute apology video, which, again, I did watch in full, so I do want to put that out there.
The final shot for Tati was essentially that James kind of promoted a rival product.
It's not a good friend. He's not supporting her business.
Here's the thing, though. It's like, Boo's got to collect his coin. I'm just playing devil advocate here.
Right, but here's the thing. Also, go on. I'm sorry.
Oh, no, I'm just sorry. I mean, the final straw was that he promoted a rival product and she wasn't down for it. He did apologize and recognize what that would do, especially because Tati has been a mentor for James when he was coming up in the beauty industry, and he of course, has taken off. But, like, with that specific issue, I feel like 45-minute video, kind of...
She laid it all out there.
Kind of dragging him was a lot for that.
She laid it all out there. Yeah. She had a lot of receipts, longer than CVS, that she wanted to pull out.
That's true.
I'm just going to say one thing. No amount of money could interfere with our friendship.
Right.
And I would never throw you under the bus because, you know, if you had a product, for example, and another in your competing product came to me and wanted me to post for you,
you wouldn't do
that.
It?
Would no, no amount of money is worth you and I losing our friendship.
That's fair, but also if we were real friends, I could come to you and be like, hey, they want me to promote this. What should I do? I mean, I really, you know what I mean? Like, there's an approach to do it. You know, it's in the approach, you guys. Okay, are you taking notes?
Are you taking notes? There's a lot to keep up with.
This drama is pretty bad because while James might be losing subscribers, Tati's gaining some.
Oh, for sure.
So yeah, here
this
we have a counter.
Work.
Yeah, his number's just going down. It's kind of sad. Yeah,
on social media too, and hers keep rising on Instagram as well. I mean, but.
And again, not to...
We expected this.
I just want to, again, play the other side a little bit. We are in the time of cancel culture, which
cancel
I can't get behind.
Because
I
mean, look at Logan Paul. He's still creating videos and still making money after everyone canceled him,
But what
too.
I'm saying is, like, I'm sure there were people who started unsubscribing from James's channel without even watching Tati's video. You know what I'm saying? Like,
100%.
They just hopped on the bandwagon, in my opinion.
Right. And then, yes.
Yeah, guys, Black Twitter told me to cancel James Charles a long time ago, so...
I've not been into it for a while.
I mean, the,
because he has had a lot of drama that has followed him, which is why I feel like even now a lot of celebrities are reportedly unfollowing him as well. I mean, I do believe I put together a fancy little side by side of Kylie Jenner, Miley Cyrus, Shawn Mendes, Katy Perry, all celebrities who have reportedly unfollowed James Charles in the wake of this controversy. You know, it's so crazy because as I see people like Shawn Mendes, and then I look through Twitter, I see kind of older receipts being pulled out of uncomfortable conversations. Like, do you remember when Shawn Mendes did a live and James Charles hopped in it and said something a little weird, a little uncomfortable?
And it's those things that are starting to float back up to the surface. Some stuff we never even heard about.
Right.
Like, should we talk about Zara Larsson?
Yes, Zara Larsson, you guys, this tweet is now deleted, but right after the whole Tati and James videos came out, she said, I'm cackling because he hit up my boyfriend in the DM several times knowing damn well he's straight, which is something that Tati brought up in her original 45-minute right. video, which is something that has made her uncomfortable as his friend, and she has tried to have conversations with him saying, hey, you might want to tone it down because this might come back and bite you.
And it did, although you mentioned Zara did delete this tweet. Mm-hmm. She kind of clarified in another tweet saying that, I mean, basically she just said, I checked, it wasn't several times. It was only one DM and some comments under pictures, which again, that's what James has been kind of known to do.
Right, and that, of course, is Zara and her boyfriend. And like we said, those tweets are deleted, but sorry, Zara, I'm CVS too. I got the receipt.
That's right.
Also, someone else who tweeted, ironically, to Zara's tweet was Olivia O'Brien, who kind of doubled down on that, saying same sister-ish is wild. Of course, Olivia is dating fellow YouTuber Tati Smith. And apparently, I mean, seemingly kind of saying that James tried to hit up Tati in a way.
And this is probably less surprising, but obviously lines are being drawn in the sand when it comes to Tati versus James. Jeffree Star got in on it. I think we know whose side he's on.
Yes, and this is also deleted too.
This is also deleted. He said, there's a reason that Nathan banned James Charles from ever coming over to our home again. There's a reason why I haven't seen him since Glam Life Guru's birthday in February. He is a, quote, danger to society. And he says, everything Tati said is 100% true.
I mean, people coming out of the woodwork to chime in on this conversation. Like we said,
some people that don't even make sense.
Whose side are you on? Yeah, some people who don't make
sense. Some people I'm like scratching my head.
Insert Cardi B.
Yeah,
you guys, this one's funny. We just wanted to bring light to it. Cardi B had tweeted in the midst of all of this, a friend that tells your business over a dispute was never your friend. Well, someone on Twitter goes, well, considering he was never a friend to her, then I guess there was no friendship to be had. So joke is still on him. Well, Cardi has no idea what in the world is going on.
Or that what we're talking about.
So she says, I'm looking at these comments and I don't know what the hell y'all talking about. Sorry, I probably should not have said that out loud.
I can't blur my own mouth. Anything that happened over the weekend, they're applying to this drama right here. And even Cardi's like,
Cardi's
what?
Something completely different.
She's talking about Game of Thrones, you guys. It is time to get into it. And for this, we need to bring Brianna back in because she is the Got Queen, you guys. This is her show.
Because I don't watch the show.
The Got Queen, I like that.
That's you. You deserve the Iron Throne. All right, Brianna, what is everybody talking about with the latest Got episode?
Oh, my gosh. Everybody has a lot of thoughts and feelings after last night's episode. So last night was the penultimate episode called The Bells, which means it's the second to last episode of the series. The general consensus, I think most people, well, people are a little divided. Some people loved it. Some people, like me, thought it was terrible. But there
you weren't alone there.
No.
What were they so upset with? And obviously, those who watch ET Live know that I don't watch Game of Thrones. I could not make it past the first episode.
But I just watched the ones everyone's talking about.
Were they upset about what happened in the plot, or were they upset about? Are they still not over the Starbucks?
I was going to say, is there a cup in this episode?
No, it's not like flubs or anything. It's mostly just like the character development from like the past seven seasons of the show has just been thrown out the window essentially for a lot of our favorite characters, and like also like some of the deaths were very underwhelming. Like we expected Cersei to have this grand like murder, and it was just it just wasn't good.
Spoiler alert, how did she die?
So okay, we'll get to that. We're gonna start with some just of like the other more memorable moments because it was a very kind of funny episode.
That's what the season has become. It's just a bunch of memes. Yeah.
Yeah. So this clip right here is when Sandor and his brother, the Mountain, who is Cersei's bodyguard, were about to do their much anticipated Clegane Bowl, where they basically fight to the death, essentially. So everyone was talking about this one because of the way Cersei just kind of like scoots by. It's right after her hand Qyburn is killed, and she's kind of just there alone. So she just kind of like, excuse me, this seems like a family matter. Let me just move out the way.
This does not concern me. I am out. Thank you very much.
Exactly.
Bye.
So if we show 29, this was one of the memes that I liked that I thought was so funny. Cersei after the Mountain slam dunked Qyburn. Yeah, I'ma just head out.
That's exactly what that was.
That's exactly what happened. So let's get into how she died now. So in
the good stuff.
Let's show 31. So Cersei and her brother Jaime, we all know, are twins. And
the first episode, I know what they did.
Yeah, exactly.
Bad.
And they're unfortunately in love with each other. So a lot of people.
Oh my God.
Yeah, a lot of people were upset that Jaime went back to Cersei because he was with Brienne and they were in the north and they were chilling. But he decided he had to go back to Cersei, and they kind of just like died down in the crypts together. Yeah, after
some
like
Romeo and Juliet.
Exactly.
Right here.
Yeah, it's while like Dany's burning the entire city, and so everyone's dead. Her hand is dead. Her bodyguard is dead. All her family's dead. She had actually tried to kill Jaime, so it's a little surprising that he comes back there, and they die together in each other's arms. So it was just a little underwhelming. Everyone was pretty upset. Like
I saw some fans defending it a little bit, though, saying that they got this intimate, sweet moment.
I was gonna say it's pretty dramatic. What more could
but
you
like,
want?
But like, I mean, I feel like that is also like, you know, an ending we probably didn't expect for them, but one that they deserved. Don't
yeah, I wouldn't say they deserved it. No, okay. Cersei definitely deserved to die in a blaze of fire. Yes, yeah. Like Arya should have killed her. Dany should have killed her. Anyone should have killed her. Her dying in her brother's loving arms after she had just tried to kill him the episode prior. I don't think that worked.
I must be a hopeless romantic, but I know that's not what this show is. So I get it. Meanwhile, I'm like, oh, that's so cute. Right. That's how I want to go. Just kidding.
Yeah,
I'm all sorts of confused over here.
Okay. Wait, Brianna, you mentioned there wasn't really a flub, but some fans were pointing out a potential one that I know you're going to clear up for us about Jamie's hand.
Yes.
So, everyone's tweeting about it.
Jaime, as we know, does not have a hand. He lost it back in season 3 or 4, I think, and he has now season 3, and he has now a gold hand. So,
well, it's Game of Thrones. Anything can happen, right?
Well, I mean, hopefully no hands regrowing, but it seems like in this still, like, you can see his hand is there, but this wasn't in the actual show. It was just like a promo still, I think, right, of the episode. So everyone was like, oh, it's another Starbucks cup, but no, this
Listen,
one wasn't
they should
in the
leave,
show.
They should leave the Photoshop to me.
Yeah.
I'm good with that Photoshop. Make sure there's that, no extra
that,
hands.
That face tune.
Yeah. We remove things, not add
Absolutely,
things.
Absolutely, that part. I love it.
Okay, so there was another memorable moment. There is a scene where Arya is leaving King's Landing where all this carnage is going on. She's just survived all the fire. And all of a sudden, there's just like a white horse that comes out of nowhere. Like, literally everything is burning, and there's just a pale white horse that shows up to, I guess, take her off into the sunset. I don't know. But people loved it. They thought it was really funny. And this one was one of my favorite ones. The horse waiting for things to calm down so you can pick up Arya. Which
that is
pretty
funny.
And also, this next one, Cassie, you'll like this one. Let's go 36. It's like if you can hear what's playing
I can hear
in the back.
Yep.
Is it what I think it is?
The sound of my nightmares, yes. Just
yes, it is. Old Town Road.
Old Town Road.
That's genius. I love the internet.
Lil Nas X.
I may not be the biggest fan of Game of Thrones, but
that's
gotta
so
love the
good,
internet
guys.
Coming in clutch.
Oh, yeah.
Shout
the internet that wins.
One. That is that's the content I strive for. Okay,
yeah.
That's it right there.
All right, so these last two ones that we have, basically in the show, Dany, before she burns up the whole city, they say, okay, well, if they ring these bells, then the city's surrendering. Don't burn them up. But they rang the bells. She kind of ignored it. And
Girl,
she burned the whole city up.
Oh, Phil Lewis underscore.
Girl, I didn't hear nothing. I can, like, hear that.
And we can go to the last one. And this is the last one we've got for today. Because in the last episode, her friend and her confidant, Missandei, died, and she said Dracarys, which basically means how she gets the dragons to burn up everything. And she yelled at Dracarys right before she died, and now she's just sitting up in heaven like, this isn't what I meant.
So people are dying left and right, huh? Who's left for the
we were
last
expecting that,
final
though, right?
episode?
Yeah, I mean, everyone was going to die. I don't know who's left, but I'm sure there'll be way more people
Amelia
dying.
Clark for the throne!
I know, right? Well, all you Game of Thrones fans, what did you guys think of the penultimate episode? Were you satisfied? Were you expecting more? And how are you feeling going into the final
also,
episode ever?
I can't leave out the Neverthroners. If you are so confused and cannot wait for Game of Thrones to be over, let us know in the comments below, too, because you are not alone. I'm here for you and with you.
That's true. All right, guys, time for a quick hit. Kacey Musgraves is anti-debauchery, at least when it comes to chugging a drink out of her shoe. All right, let me explain. So Spacey Casey's Oh What a World tour is in Australia right now. This is her during her Sydney concert on Sunday. But look at just Kacey minding her own business, doing what she does best, sounding like an angel. Well, apparently that's where the Aussie crowd started chanting for her to do a shoey. Now, if you don't know what a shoey is, let's let Post Malone show you because he had to do it in a concert in New Zealand. Take a look. there you have it. It's literally chugging a drink, presumably a beer, out of your shoe, you guys. So they wanted Kacey Musgraves, Grammy winner, woman of my dreams, to chug a drink out of a shoe. So as you can imagine, she refused.
She did not do it.
She did not do it. What do you think of that?
She is a high class country queen. I'm sorry. You could give me a Louboutin brand new from the store and I'm still not putting alcohol in it and drinking it.
I'm not gonna lie. I would do it, but I'm trash. So I like, I would do it. Plus, you know, I love me some booze.
And by my comment, no shade to Australia. I get it's something
it's like a culture thing. Yeah, but she refused and she stood her ground. And honestly, the crowd was on her side. There was a couple tweets actually that people shared since this happened. One of them hilarious. Calling the cops on everyone cheering for Kacey Musgraves to do a shoe.
Listen, she will do just about anything, but you know what? Can't blame her for not wanting to drink out of a shoe.
I will say, she has openly talked about how she was on drugs when she wrote her Grammy-winning album, Golden Hour, but this is where she draws the line, folks. One more tweet for you. Someone wrote, she stuck it out and we stand an anti-shoey queen. I can't say I don't blame her.
All right, you guys. Sorry, puppy ears and contour filters, because Snapchat has upped the game with a gender swap and a baby filter. And you guys, celebs are getting in on all the action. Don't you worry, we did too.
Some funny, some kind of creepy.
Some very creepy, case in point mine, which we'll show you in a second. But guys, like I said, celebs are getting in on the Snapchat action. Did you see Chrissy Teigen? Literally, poor Luna. Chrissy gender swapped little Luna.
Luna is a boy now?
Luna's a little boy.
I don't know whose kid that is though. Like, that doesn't look like John, that doesn't look like Chrissy.
It's the milkman's baby.
She's blowing a kiss in her Disney princess outfit. I love it.
Miley Cyrus, you guys, also got in on the action, posted this to her Instagram story, thinking that her gender swap turned her into Joe Jonas. I don't see the resemblance, but anything to tag a Jonas brother lately, apparently.
I know. She's been hitting up the Jonas Brothers, our Disney pals.
Besides the point, but yes.
She does not look like Joe Jonas, but you know what? She's looking kind of cute as a dude. I'm not going to lie.
Who else do we have, you guys? I think we have Bad Bunny. Okay, so Bad Bunny, instead of doing the gender swap, Bad Bunny turned himself into a baby with a nose piercing. Love that.
So cute.
Not gonna lie.
This looks like him.
It looks just like him.
That's what I imagine he would look like as a baby. He was having a lot of fun with these all weekend because he did the man and the woman too. Like, he was hitting all of them, as all of us were.
I'm not gonna lie. I did not have fun doing it because I was
scared out
of my mind. So I did. Oh, God. I'm scarred for life. No one
can see. Cassie, you're so handsome.
Okay. All right. So I did.
You're a really handsome guy.
It's just jarring.
This is the gender swap. And mind you, I had no makeup on, nothing. I'm literally wearing like my Syracuse hoodie. But here's the thing. When I took this photo, I freaked out because I look just like my brother. Yeah. It's not even funny. I put together a side-by-side. That's my brother. That's me. We literally look. He has a little bit more scruff than me there. But it's so bizarre how... I mean, yes, we share the same blood and we are from the same parents, but like, it's crazy to think how much you look like your sibling.
I'm not gonna lie, the more I look at it, Cass, I'm like, okay. All right.
Well, you gender swapped this morning.
I turned into a woman.
And you were cute.
And I had to do a video.
Oh my God, she's beauty and she's great.
She's getting her glow up. You are beautiful.
I don't know about that. I look a little really rough. Good. You think so, Brianna?
Yes, both of you guys look really good, actually.
I can literally hear
What's
people
in the control
room.
It's me here at makeup room, like getting my, you know, daily blowout, but this time on my long locks. I don't know how I look as a girl, but I'll tell you what, I make one cute baby. Let's take a look. This is not what I look like as a kid, but tell me this is not baby's first haircut.
This is the cutest thing in the world.
I'm so here for it.
You still are cute right now, but like, I mean, I knew. I wish we were baby friends.
Like, we're baby friends.
I wish we were friends. We were babies.
I feel like in another life we were.
Oh, guys.
All right, time to get into another quick hit, because this is another story that has been tracking all weekend long.
Constance, like a baby.
Woo. I mean, let me rewind for you guys who I might have missed it over the weekend. Mm-hmm. It all started when we heard that Fresh Off the Boat was renewed for a sixth season. Now, around that same time, Constance Wu, the star of the show and also of Crazy Rich Asians, seemingly tweeted that she was not thrilled about the renewal. In fact, we have the tweets for you guys. She tweeted, so upset right now that I'm crying. Ugh. F.
And at first, we didn't know if this was directly related to it.
And then there was even a second one.
Yes.
And then she said she doubled down with Evan Hell. But you're right. We didn't know what she was actually referring to until a fan said, hey, congratulations, great news. To which she replied, no, it's not. And guess what, Cass? In true celebrity fashion, that tweet has been deleted, but we got it. We have the receipts. Mm-hmm. So anyways, guys, she later apologized, saying that that's not what she meant. She was just upset that because the show was renewed, she is missing out on another project. Either way.
Oh, you have two jobs. Wow.
I know.
So sorry.
And that's the thing. Right now, it's upfront. So in the TV world, a lot of series are finding out whether they're renewed and returning.
Or canceled
on network shows. A lot of them were canceled. So you can imagine, like, you know, people are, like, dragging concepts.
People are probably actually upset over this. Exactly. Meanwhile, she's, upset that she has two projects in the works.
But the folks who are getting a renewal are having a lot of fun with Constance Wu. She has become a meme now, guys. Four people celebrating that their series is returning. Case in point, Seth MacFarlane. His show, The Orville, got a third season pickup. He tweeted, oh, effing goddamn hell, F-F-D-S. I can't even say
you
it.
You can't even say that
no,
one.
No, I can't. And then Alison Tolman, she got some really good news. Her show, Emergence, moved from NBC to ABC with a whole series order. She tweeted, effing hell, in a good way.
I said, gotta give him props for being able to turn that sitch right around and make it funny.
Poor Constance, though. I know. Ooh, girl. Seemed a little petty, not gonna lie.
Little petty.
All right, finally. Actually, we got a couple more stories for you guys. Chris Evans attended his high school reunion.
Because that is so Chris Evans.
And
we
love
him for that.
It was a couple weeks ago, to be fair, but the pictures are starting to surface, you guys, okay?
And people are starting to notice one in particular thing about these photos. Well, not that red carpet beautiful photo, but he wore a name tag. To his high school reunion, just in case anybody may not have recognized him from, like, you know, the entire MCU franchise, Avengers Endgame. Have you heard that movie?
Or Endgame, which has crossed $2 billion worldwide. Have you heard of it?
Look, he still puts on a name tag that says Chris.
Some folks were like, this is the most Chris Evans thing to happen to Chris Evans. And you know what? I'm going to defend him a little bit, because what did you expect? He can't show up and not wear a name tag when everyone else is wearing
Because then you look like an a-hole.
Then you're like, huh, you know who I am. So, you know, like, I think it's perfect. I'm so glad he did this. Look at him. He looks so normal. This is Captain America out here acting like he ain't Captain America.
This adorable meatball just dreadful underscore says. I love that.
I love it. I love it. All right, you guys. It is time for our MVP most viral post. We're not done talking about Game of Thrones, guys. I mean, the question that a lot of fans are asking is this the best season ever? Some people feel like it might be the worst season ever. All I know is that every time there's a new episode, y'all have something to say about it, and now there's a meme supporting it, and it's actually...
from our own footage.
It's our own interview. E.T.'s Michelle Turner talked to Emilia Clarke at the Game of Thrones Emmys after party, I should say HBO after party, and her soundbite is giving this new season, season is giving this soundbite a whole new context. Should we take a listen? Do we have the audio, Brianna? Okay, so she's saying here, she's trying to skirt the answer to a question.
Michelle
so
had asked her if Emilia had shot her final scenes yet, and like Emilia didn't even want to answer that. And you see her like eyes light up and try to like look away really quick, and best season ever!
That's all she can say, you guys, is through her teeth. Best season ever! And now people are using it to describe their disdain for the latest episodes.
Gotta love our interviews going viral.
It's very, very true.
I can't even keep track of all of our ET interviews this year.
Lady Gaga.
Yep.
Lady Gaga got the Golden Gloves. It certainly looks that way. Yeah. That's Constance Wu when she returns
to work. If you guys don't know what we're talking about right now, just check the internet, because it's on
Maybe we'll show you on tomorrow's download. All right, that does it for today, you guys. Thanks so much for watching. Again, leave your comments in the comment section below.
Because I read them.
And we read them, and
I
care, okay? I'm Denise.